I'm here at the Goose and Jim in Van Nuys. We have to hear and see a very inspirational story about Sam Masonueve. He's from Canada. He's an amateur fighter that competes, that has dreams. He's working on it right now with Joe Goosen to go to the Olympics in Japan in 2020. But when he was born, he had very, very serious medical problems. The doctors didn't know if he'll be able to walk, if he'll ever go to school. Right now, he's 16 years old, he's 17, he graduated high school already, graduated early, he's boxing and competing. We caught up with him to hear about his journey and what advice does he have for people who are going through tough medical problems right now.
Joe is a big art, he's a very good trainer. He's my dad, my mom, my doctor. Oh, thanks.
We were just doing some doctoring today.
Let me paraphrase.
Yeah.
Sammy was born with some serious, serious medical issues.
Yes.
That many people are not even able to walk, let alone function in society.
Yeah.
He overcame so much, and now he's a fighter in your gym. What can you tell us about him?
Well, number one, the story is always inspirational. If you've ever had a kid, if you're a parent, you know the terror of having a child born with some sort of, you know, maybe lifelong malady. And that's got to be frightening for a parent. And his father and mother are wonderful people. I know his father well. And they will stop at nothing, and they never stop at anything to get him back healthy again. I'm sure they spent a lot of money, a lot of time, a lot of tears, and a lot of praying, because, you know, he had a very serious problem. And they're just now coming around to finding out everything about this problem that he has. And he's been overcoming it for years. The amazing thing is, if you didn't know he had gone through those problems before, you wouldn't know it now.
No, I wouldn't. I thought it was like, here's Canelo. Is Canelo training at Goosen Gym?
Right. The
Canadian Canelo.
That's right.
Yeah.
But the great thing is, he's very sound athletically. And he surprised me the first time he came out here. I was expecting to see somebody really raw, really green. But no, he had something on the ball, so we've been working with him. Just got back into town this weekend, first day today.
Yeah.
Of course, I put him through the mill. I kind of brought the hammer down on him today and see what type of condition he was in. So I know where he's at right now, but he's very determined, and I wanna help him. I wanna see him succeed at whatever it is he wants to do. For somebody who's been as determined as he has to overcome this childhood illness, and believe me, it was treacherous. He's got what it takes mentally and spiritually. I don't underestimate a kid like this. And he's got talent. So
he can crack.
Oh, he can crack. Oh, he can crack. So he's very strong now.
I want to ask Sammy a question. Sammy, you just started having amateur fights. How did it feel the first time that you won and they raised your hand? What were you thinking?
Oh, my God. He's
It was a great feeling.
Yeah, it's very...
That you beat your illness
incredible.
A little bit?
Yeah, it's... I know they explain, it's very difficult.
It's hard for him to put in words, but I'm sure the most proud people in the audience were his parents, to think of what they were suffering through for years, not knowing how he was going to end up as an adolescent. I'm sure they must have thought that moment was something very special, that they had overcome what they were, you know, facing for years. So it had to have been something very special.
What advice do you have for parents who are going through a difficult time right now with a child that has an illness?
You have to believe you can pass away all the walls you have in front of you.
How do you do it?
I didn't listen to the doctor. Mm-hmm. I'm going outside of the doctor. Hyperbaric room, all alternative medical care, and we win with that. We win.
So he's a champion without even having one professional fight yet?
Yes.
What message, both you guys, do you have for people right now who are fighting an illness, who want to give up? What would you tell them?
If you don't, you know, let the illness get to you, but you're determined to beat it, and you're determined to work hard, and of course, you know, find the right doctor, of course, you can overcome anything in life, you know? And we've seen it before, Ellie. You know, there's a million examples out there of people that have gone to war, lost limbs, had terminal illnesses that they've beaten and come back. Those are the great inspiring stories for us.
Sammy, if you could fight one professional fighter right now, who would you want to fight?
Oh, it's a very difficult question.
You love Manny Pacquiao?
Yeah.
You want Pacquiao? Good fight?
Yeah, I'm away.
Yeah, that's for a parent, just that the child is out being able to enjoy himself and live a normal life, that's victory enough.
We take everything for granted that we can breathe, but nothing is given, nothing is obvious. If you can't do it, then your life is very difficult. All right, thank you very much. I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Japan 2020, we will see you at the Olympics. FaceNewsReporting.com, I'm Elisek back reporting.